Hello, UTC, and welcome to another edition of Mox News. I'm Jillian Henson. Hope everyone had a great and safe spring break, but now let's take a look into campus news. All May and August graduates, come celebrate your graduation in the University Center Bookstore tomorrow, Tuesday, March 20th, from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Wednesday, March 21st, from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Ball 4 and the UTC Bookstore will be on hand to handle all graduation orders for cap and gowns, diploma displays, and other graduation items. The UTC Alumni Office will also be there to help new graduates on how to find a job, stay connected to UTC, and get involved in activities, and a special drawing for UTC Alumni Sweatshirt will be held. Also in campus news, UTC is looking for a new provost. If you're interested in meeting the candidates for the first two provosts, Dr. Jack Thomas and Dr. Phil Oldham will be on campus next week. There will be an open session for faculty, staff, students, and the community Tuesday, March 20th from 2:30 to 3:30 p.m. in the Signal Mountain Room at the University Center, and for Dr. Thomas, and for one March 23rd at 2:30 to 3:30 p.m. in Fletcher 100. And in local news, two men from Monroe, Georgia were found dead in Alton Park just before midnight Saturday, and police said it was an apparent murder-suicide. Chattanooga Police Major Crimes Detectives were called to the park after the bodies were discovered. Patrol officers responded to an unknown trouble call. When the patrol officers arrived, they found the bodies of Irwin Griggs, 54, and Herbert Johnson, 45, both of Monroe, Georgia. And in sports, a celebration for three outstanding UTC athletic teams will be held at noon on Friday, March 23rd, to honor the Lady Mox basketball team, UTC wrestling team, and the UTC cross-country team. The UTC Pep Band elites, cheerleaders, Sugar Mox, coaches, and team members will gather on Lansing Court between the McClellan Gym and the UC. The campus and community are invited and refreshments will be served. Parking is available in the East 5th Street parking garage. So congratulations, UTC Athletics, for a job well done. And in basketball, the Lady Mox cut an 11-point halftime deficit to just 1 point 10 minutes into the second half, but couldn't hold on as Baylor claimed a 68-55 NCAA first-round win over Chattanooga at the RBC Convention Center Saturday afternoon in Raleigh, North Carolina. Chattanooga closes out the year with a 25-8 mark. Now let's take a look at our weather. Today, partly cloudy with a high of 69 and a low of 48. Tuesday, partly cloudy with a high of 65, low of 58. And Wednesday, high of 71 with a low of 51. That's all for this edition of Mox News. Make sure you watch every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday on Comcast Channel 3 or on demand at moxnews.com. That's all for this edition. I'm Jillian Henson. Have a great day.